Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the first seminar of the year. Today we have Esat as our speaker. Esat is actually a graduate of the Electrical Engineering Department from METU. We co-supervise his thesis with Aydin Alatan. He obtained his bachelor degree from Boğaziçi University in Electrical Engineering as well. And he's currently pursuing his PhD degree in the Informatics Institute. Which department in Informatics?
Multimedia.
Multimedia Informatics, okay. And he's currently working as a team leader at Autodidactic Technologies. Okay, so the screen is yours.
Thank you, Sinan Hocam. Here it is my thesis presentation. It's exploring this deep spatial temporal fusion architectures towards late temporal modeling of human action recognition. As mentioned, my advisor is Aydin Alatan and my co-supervisor is Sinan Kalkan. Beginning with the definition, action recognition is the identification of predefined actions from short videos, which is generally which are from generally 5 to 15 seconds. It's a classification problem, and there are two important information to recognize an action. The first one is spatial information, which is the static information existing in a single frame. The second information is the temporal information, which is the integration of static information over frames. In the figure, there are two types of swimming styles. The person, water, and the relationship between them are related with spatial information, and swimming action can be recognized by only using these. However, to make a discrimination between front crawl and breaststroke, there is also need to utilize temporal information. So before the introduction of deep learning, people rely on the handcrafted representations. To create a representation, there are three main steps. The first one is the selection of interest points. These can be the sparse interest points, such as Harris 3D, or these points in dense trajectories, in which points are tracked with optical flow. After determining the interest points, descriptors are extracted around the interest points, and these descriptors are special descriptors, such as Hawk, or special temporal descriptors, such as SIFT-3D. Then all of the descriptors from a video is encoded in order to create a fixed-size meaningful representations by using bag of words, Fisher vector, or VLAT, or etc. There are various deep learning concepts for action recognition task, and this figure can be given as the general overview of the concepts. In the figure, blue boxes are traditional 2D CNN architectures, and gray boxes are 3D CNN architectures. As I mentioned before, creating temporal information is crucial for action recognition, and all of these examples are basically focusing on temporal information. Part A is related with the recurrent architectures and is a type of late temporal modeling on the extracted features of 2D CNN architectures. Part B is 3D CNN architecture, where temporal information is processed not only at the end, but hierarchically from beginning to end, enabling 3D CNNs becomes beneficial over late temporal pooling strategies. Part C is known as the first version of two-stream architectures, and one of the streams is trained with multiple frames of optical flow in order to benefit from temporal information, and each stream is trained independently, and their scores are averaged or weighted. Part D seems to be a late temporal pooling strategy with 3D convolution, but fusion is also an important keyword here, and fusion can also be implemented in intermediate steps, and each streams can be trained jointly, and the main goal is to utilize complementary information of different modalities better. Part three is two-stream 3D CNN architectures, where temporal information is highlighted on both streams. So let's continue with 3D convolution. In traditional 2D CNN architectures, the input is four-dimensional, where B is the batch size, C in is the number of input channels, H and W are spatial dimensions, and filter of them have three dimensions. In 3D CNN architectures, the inputs become five-dimensional, and filter size becomes four-dimensional with the addition of temporal dimension. For the figure, Part A is basic 2D convolution operation. In these figures, assume that the number of input channels is 1 for simplicity and for ease of demonstration. To process multiple frames with 2D CNN, as in part B, one way is to place temporal information into the channel dimension. But the temporal information is damaged by reducing its dimension to 1 after 2D convolution. Part C is the 3D convolution in which the temporal information is preserved at the output. Inflated 3D or i3D, it's a typo here, it's inflated 3D, the known name, but it's an inception 3D, inception architecture actually, is the 3D CNN version of the inception architecture and can be assumed as the breakthrough of the 3D CNN architecture. You can notice from the figure that all operations are demonstrated with three dimensions, which also include temporal operations. These are the example 3D ResNet basic and bottleneck blocks. So let's continue with group convolution concept. Group convolution is the idea of reducing the channel interactions by grouping the channels. The number of groups is also known as cardinality. Figure one demonstrates that the difference of demonstrates the difference of group convolution. As you can see, only the channels within the groups are interacted with each other. The implementation reduces the complexity and memory utilization proportionally with K. ResNext is the group convolution version of ResNet architecture. One by one convolutions are known as pointwise convolution, and they do not have group convolution and preserve the complete channel interactions. Only the middle block in the ResNext architecture, ResNext bottleneck block, has a group convolution, not the pointwise convolutions. Multi-fiber networks, MFNet, also utilizes the idea of group convolution and is a type of ResNet architecture. MFNet applies the pointwise convolutions only before the group convolution, not after it, in order to reduce the computational burden, and this special pointwise block is called as multiplexer. It also reduces the number of channels of ResNet architecture. You can think MFNet as the mobile net of action recognition from the number of parameters perspective. It's a lightweight version. In separable 3D convolution, the spatial and the temporal convolutions are implemented separately from each other as seen in the figure. The advantage of it is that it decreases the computational complexity and number of parameters. In the literature, ResNet version of separable convolution is known as R2 plus 1D, and i3D version of it is known as S3D. Now, temporal shift modules. Instead of utilizing 3D convolution, TSM shifts the channel information across the temporal dimension in 2D convolution in order to model the temporal information. However, shift ratio is hyperparameter, and more shifts creates better temporal relation but worsen the spatial information. The extra computational complexity of it is 2-3% to the 2D CNN architectures. Slow-fast architecture takes its inspiration from P and M type retinal ganglion cells in visual cortex. 80% of the cells in the retinal ganglion are P type, and they are responsible from the spatial details, but have a low response capability. M type is less than P type, but has a fast response ability. Similar to this analogy, slow-path has a greater channel capacity as the dominance of P-type cells, but low temporal resolution. On the contrary, fast pathway has a low channel capacity. You can see here as the beta channel, the number of channels is less in fast pathway, but has a better temporal resolution, which corresponds to the high frame rate in the figure. There are also lateral connections from fast to slow path in this architecture. Another concept is motion augmented RGB stream networks, MARS. In the MARS implementation, the main idea depends on distillation. Distillation is basically the transfer of information from one network to the other one. In the MARS, RGB architecture is distilled with optical flow architecture. In the loss function of MARS, There are two terms, and the second part, the first part is classical categorization laws, cross entropy, but the second part is related with the distillation concept, where MSE laws is applied between the features of RGB and flow architectures. The main importance of this implementation is that without increasing the computational complexity in the inference of RGB architecture, its performance increases thanks to the distillation concept. Non-local block. The main aim of non-local block is to create global relations in the intermediate parts of the CNN architectures because convolution operation is a local operation. For this aim, it utilizes the attention mechanism. You can see the example non-local block in the figure. There are theta, pi, and g functions which learns convenient subspaces for attention mechanism. The attention weights are obtained with the matrix multiplication of output of theta and pi functions for all spatial temporal locations, which is multiplication of t, h, and w. Then these attention weights are applied to the output of g functions. Then the output of non-local block is added to the original input, making it possible to implement any architecture. Another important thing related with non-local paper is the architecture. And I name it as modified ResNet in my study and in my experiments. In the figure, you can see that on the left, there is a standard 3D bottleneck block. In the middle, there is a standard 2D bottleneck block. And on the right, there is a version of separable 3D bottleneck block. In the modified ResNet, the middle and the right bottleneck blocks are implemented in an alternating way, and non-local block is also added in an alternating way. BERT recently has become the popular concept in NLP tasks due to its success. The main idea of it depends on the multi-head attention concept. In the figure on the left, you can see that scaled dot product attention units. The attention concept of it is very similar with non-local. Theta, pi, and g functions of non-local is realized with linear layers instead of convolution layers. There is also a scale block which normalizes attention weights with input dimension. On the right of the on the right figure, multiple scale dot product attention units are utilized, which is to learn multiple relations, which is called multi-head attention. The training of BERT includes unsupervised pre-training step in which the masked words are guessed and estimated and additionally, architecture estimates whether the selected two sentences are next to each other or not. Then the pre-trained weights are utilized in the related classification tasks. So let's move on to proposed methods. Continuing with the motivation, in all of the 3D CNN architectures, temporal global average pooling layer T-gap is utilized. The important fact behind the motivation of this study is that features before T-gap layer of 3D CNNs has a different temporal characteristic because although the receptive fields of different temporal features might cover the whole clip, the effective receptive field has a Gaussian distribution, which means that the effect of each frame on different temporal features is not equal. For this reason, we are considering that T-gap decreases the richness of temporal information by weighting different temporal features equally. This is problematic because one of the temporal features might be more important than the others to recognize an action. Additionally, it destroys the temporal order information, which can be important to recognize some actions. So we propose to remove T-gap layer in order to benefit from the temporal information better. This removal enables us to utilize late temporal modeling concept with 3D CNN architectures. In the action recognition literature, these two concepts are perceived as different branches because late temporal modeling is applied on the extracted features of different frames by using 2D CNN architectures. For late temporal modeling, we prefer using a self-attention-based model, namely BERT, because of its superior success in NLP tasks. The proposed BERT-based late temporal modeling architecture is presented in the figure. The most important mechanism of BERT architecture is the attention mechanism. With this mechanism, BERT learns which temporal feature is more important for better recognition. With multi-hand attention, it learns multiple relations. Another technique existing in BERT architecture is positional encoding, which is claimed to preserve the order information. The final crucial mechanism of BERT is the classification token. After positional encoding, additional learnable representation X CLS is added, and the attention weights of other temporal features are determined by this representation. To highlight, our BERT implementation does not have unsupervised pre-training part of BERT architecture and only used for attention mechanism. These are the input modalities of our experiments. Left is RGB modality. Middle is X and Y components of optical flow modality extracted with TV-L1 method. Right is pose modality extracted with open pose method, and pose information is converted to RGB in our study. You can see the pre-training datasets and fine-tuning datasets in our study. Pre-training ways of pre-training datasets are obtained from the related GitHub repositories. And our study basically worked on the fine-tuning datasets, and we basically take the pre-training weights of the existing studies, which is trained with Kinetics 400 and IG 65 million. Kinetics 400 is very popular in action recognition literature. IG 65 million is only is the Instagram dataset, which is created by Facebook and not available publicly. And fine-tuning datasets, HMDB 51 and UCF 101. There are 51 class in HMDB 51 and 101 class in UCF. HMDB is, and UCF is, it contains so much, I mean, correlated videos. And HMDB is collected from the Hollywood datasets, and UCF 101 is collected from the YouTube videos. Evaluations are implemented at top one and sometimes also top two stray accuracy in my thesis study. This shows the late temporal modeling performance on 2D CNN architectures with RGB modality. Among these pooling types, concatenation pooling types are the best, and BERT is the second best in this table. Note that non-local here is not a standard non-local architecture where multiple non-local blocks are placed some points of the architecture. In here, there is just a single non-local block, which is just before the pooling layer, in order to create special temporal relations. Non-local increase the performance of average pooling, but decreases the performance of concatenation pooling. We also studied to fuse the features from the intermediate steps of the architecture. In the figure, you can see an example ResNet 18 architecture with its layers. In the table, there are 4 fusion types. No fusion is basically the direct usage of features of convolutional 5 layer. Dual fusion is the concatenation of convolutional 5 and convolutional 4 layer. Triple diffusion and quadruple fusion also goes like that. Until quadruple fusion, there is an improvement. The reason behind the deterioration of quadruple fusion might be the direct gradient flow to the low-level ImageNet pre-trained weights. In 2D CNN architectures, my starting point is the ImageNet pre-training weights, basically. So this is my suggestion to the worsening of the top one accuracy. So in this part, we pick some of the concepts from the late temporal modeling and fusion studies, and the selected choices are presented in the table. Firstly, BERT was not the best for RGB modality, but here it is the best for flow, both flow and pose modality. Another interesting point is that concatenation is even worse than the average pooling for flow modality, and triple fusion makes the concatenation even worse for flow modality. So it is interesting that the performance of concepts depends on the modality. You can see the results of all modalities, two-stream and 3D stream architectures for ResNet 18 and ResNet 101. From two-stream results, we can understand that RGB and flow streams learn complementary information to each other. Addition of pose information further improves the performance of two-stream architectures. As you can see, there is a 3% in the ResNet 18 architecture and 4% in ResNet 101 architecture. So as a summary, concatenation is best for RGB modality, but BERT is best for flow and pose modalities among average pooling, LSTM, and convolutional GRU. Fusion of intermediate features is a beneficial strategy for RGB and pose modality. Addition of non-local block just before average pooling is a good strategy, but bad before concatenation. Although pose modality is worse than RGB and flow, it learns complementary information to both RGB and flow modality. Now let's continue the experiments of 3D CNN architectures. You can see the results of all 3D CNN architectures. Now we are going to investigate the ablation study in 3D CNN architectures. This table analyzes the effect of clip length, group convolution, and input resolution by using the HMDB51 datasets. In the table, 16F and 64F denotes the number of frames in the clip during the training. In the inference, again, almost all of the frames are utilized. The pretrained word in the table is important because from this point, all of the experiments utilizes the pretrained kinetic weights, and 16F pretrained means that 16 framed clips are utilized in pretraining, but it is still possible to use 64 framed clips in fine tuning. Firstly, ResNext, which includes group convolution, is better than ResNet architecture with 2%. Utilizing longer clips only in fine tuning increases top one accuracy about 5%. Utilizing longer clips also in pretraining increases the 5% more. Increasing input resolution from 112 to 224 only in fine tuning increases the performance about 1.5%. So you can see the results of the all 3D CNN architectures and TSM, which is the 2D CNN with shift operations. 8F, 16F, and 64F denotes the number of clips. There are also terms like 8 cross 8F and 32 cross 2F, in which the second number denotes the stride parameter and the effective clip coverage is 64 frames again. 112 and 224 denotes the input resolution. First of all, the best architecture from the accuracy perspective is slow-fast architecture in equal condition. I will explain the better two results in the final two rows. Secondly, the effect of distillation concept is shown with ResNext 101 Mars, where architecture does not change, but only the training procedure. And the performance improvement is dramatic with 7% increase. Thirdly, the effect of pretraining dataset is shown on R2+1D architecture, and the performance increase is again dramatic with 7.5%, which is pretrained with IG 65 million. In addition to this, non-local neural implementation improves the performance when frame selection is 32 by 2F, but not when frame selection is 64F. I don't know the exact reason of this result, but one possible reason is the increase of special temporal points utilized in attention. But I don't have a clear explanation to this fact, actually. MFNet is the best architecture from the number of parameters perspective. ResNext 101 with 16F is a good from computational perspective, but its top one is low. When all factors is considered, TSM 58xF is also a good architecture choice.
Esat, sorry, can you again clarify the difference between, for example, the last row and the same version four rows above?
Okay, I will explain. If you exclude the last two rows, all of them is trained with RGB, and only we are testing the architecture performance. But in the, ResNext 101 Mars, Izonike 64F, if you remember from the previous slides, there is an, distillation concept, which augments the optical flow information to the RGB information. The inference, again, similar to the previous architectures, only uses RGB modality again. But in the training part, there is a distillation from the optical flow. So, despite the fact that the same input modality is utilized, the distillation concept has improved the performance performance increase increased from the 73% to 80%, about 80% without increasing any number of parameters and number of operations in the inference time. But in the training, there is an optical flow distillation. In the final row, the only difference is that You can see, I mean, there is an, I mean, reference here. I haven't trained this one, but there is an, a paper reference that the pre-training, if we change the pre-training data sets from the Kinetics 400 to IG 65 million, actually IG 65 million data set is an unsupervised data set, I mean, which is collected from the hashtags of the Instagram, despite the fact that it's an weakly supervised, sorry, it's not unsupervised, it's a weakly supervised data set. Despite the fact that it's an weakly supervised data set, the number of some, the increase, because of the increase in the number of samples in the data set, the performance of the same architecture has increased dramatically in the, with the fine tuning of HMDB 51. So may I continue?
Yep, thank you.
Okay. As a summary, increasing the clip length, increasing the clip length and input resolution of the architecture and group convolution concept increases the performance of 3D CNN architectures. The best 3D CNN architecture is slow fast, distillation concept, and the scale of the proteinic data sets, even if collected with weak labels, increases the performance of architectures significantly without increasing the inference complexity. So now let's move on to proposed methods. Another thing that is implemented in our study is feature dimension reduction. The parameter complexity of BERT is quadratic with the feature dimension. For instance, if we directly apply the BERT to Resnex backbone without feature dimension reduction, BERT will have more parameter than the backbone itself. For feature dimension reduction, we propose two possible solutions. These solutions are feature reduction with modified block, FRMB, and feature reduction with additional block, FRAB. Normally, the Resnex 101 has an output dimension of 248. In FRMB, the final bottleneck block is replaced so that the output feature dimension becomes 512. In FRAB, the backbone is not changed, but the new bottleneck block is added to reduce the dimension. FRMB is more parameter efficient than FRAB, but if pre-training weights are utilized in FRMB, if pre-training weights are utilized, FRMB lose the weights of the final bottleneck block. So let's start here with the ablation study. Resnex 101 backbone is chosen for this analysis, and the analysis are implemented on HMDB 51 datasets. In the action recognition literature, the architectures are trained with SGD. However, for the training of BERT, ADAM is utilized. For a better generalization in optimization, we prefer to use ADAMW instead of ADAM. From this table, we observed that ADAMW is better than SGD in fine-tuning on HMDB 51. The addition of FRMB reduces the performance with 1%, but also decreases the number of parameters with about 3 million. For comparison of pooling strategies, compared to average pooling, LSTM worsens the performance, but concatenation type poolings and BERT increases the performance. Among the concatenation pooling types, the addition of fully connected layer after concatenation also increases the performance, but addition of non-local block before concatenation worsens the performance. BERT has obtained the best result with less parameter and less computational complexity compared to baseline implementation. Following the ablation study, we are going to investigate the impact of BERT for different 3D CNN backbones and modalities by using the split one of HMDB 51. For Resnex 101 backbone, BERT with FRMB increased the performance in all modalities with better parameter and computational complexity, computational complexity efficiency thanks to FRMB. For I3D, again, BERT increased the performance for all modalities. However, the improvements are less compared to Resnex 101 backbone. You can also observe that FRAB is important to reduce the number of parameters of BERT implementation. Before continuing the experiment result of SlowFast, we should look at the possible BERT implementations of SlowFast architecture. The different aspect of SlowFast from the other is that it has two streams, namely fast and slow streams, for single RGB modality, and these two streams have different temporal resolution, which can be seen in figure. It is 32 for a fast stream and 8 for slow stream. The proposed BERT implementations are early fusion BERT and late fusion BERT. In the early fusion BERT, the features from two different paths are concatenated before the implementation of BERT, and single BERT module is utilized. In the late fusion BERT, each stream has its own BERT, and concatenation is performed after BERT implementation. The possible downside of early fusion is that the temporal resolution of fast stream is reduced for proper concatenation. However, possible advantage of early fusion is that the attention is applied jointly to the features of fast and slow stream. Here, it is applied differently in different BERT modules. For slow-fast architecture, both BERT fusion strategies is better than the baseline. However, the improvement of early fusion is very limited, implying that preserving the temporal resolution of fast stream is more important than joint attention on the features of slow and fast stream. Again, for R2 plus 1D architecture, BERT also increases the performance about 2 to 3%. In the slide, you can see the state of the art result of the literature for both HMDB51 and UCF101 datasets. Our BERT implementations obtains the best result on HMDB51 for both Kinetics 400 and IG65 million pre-training datasets. For UCF101, it is again the best for IG65 million pre-training, but the second best for Kinetics 400. This might be because of the fact that UCF101 might contain action samples which needs less temporal reasoning than the samples of HMDB51. Now, our another proposed concept, BERT distillation. Normally, BERT is utilized in an unsupervised way during its pre-training. So just like guessing the words in NLP tasks, we try to predict the temporal features of teacher architecture by student architecture. In the distillation concept, the information flow is from teacher to the information flow is from teacher to student architecture, and the weights of teacher architecture is frozen. I want to highlight that the distilled features are not utilized directly in classification, but indirectly in student architecture. Loss function is very similar to MARS architecture. I want to highlight, misconception. I want to correctify the misconception in the figure that normally it seems like because of the BERT block, the bigger block, it seems like the student block is much bigger than the, teacher 3D cinema block, but it's not in that way. Actually, if teacher block has an advantage over, should have an advantage over the student architecture, there are, two possible implementation here. It can be used a flow architecture with the same architecture with the student architecture and the backbones will be equal to each other, the student and the teacher architectures. If we utilize the flow architecture, the teacher architecture will have an advantage over the student architecture from the perspective of the input, from the perspective of input modality, so that we distill the flow modality features to the student architecture. Another possible thing is that the teacher 3D CNN can be selected, for example, has a better network capability in RGB modality, such as, for example, R2 plus 1D pre-trained with IG65 million has a better result in 3D CNNs. Therefore, it can be utilized to pass the information of and better data set information to the small data sets. This can be perceived as from the two perspective, but BERT is only utilized in the, the student CNN architecture, not 3D CNN architecture. So maybe we can go back after the, end of the presentation. So you can see the result of BERT distillation on the table. In the table, upper part is BERT distillation and lower part is MARS distillation. The student architecture of BERT distillation is RGB ResNext 101. RGB ResNext 101 BERT, the performance improvement of BERT distillation is 1.5% when teacher architecture is flow ResNext BERT. If the teacher becomes R2 plus 1D, it again improves, but improvement is lower than flow ResNext, despite that R2 plus 1D has a better top one accuracy than flow ResNext 101. This might be because of the fact that the flow modality might contain more complementary information. For comparison with MARS distillation, firstly, when MARS distillation is implemented with HMDB51 directly, it leads to overfitting and decreases the top one accuracy. However, with Kinetics, it obtains significant improvements. We don't know What batch distillation can provide when distilled with kinetics, however, we can conclude that it is better than MARS in distillation with smaller data sets, probably because of indirect distillation of BERT, which prevents the student architectures from overfitting. As a summary, we propose joint utilization of late temporal modeling concept with 3D CNN architectures. We showed that proposed BERT-based late temporal modeling results in performance improvements for popular 3D CNN architectures, which are ResNex, i3D, SlowFast, and R2+1D. We obtained state-of-the-art results for HMDB51 and UCF101 datasets. BERT distillation is better than MARS distillation when distillation datasets is HMDB51, and it has a potential to be better when distillation datasets is Kinetics 400. So you can see what is learned by the layers of R2+1D by deep dream visualization, which is basically maximizing the output features of specific layer. As you can notice, first layer looks at low level features. Second layer looks at higher level features compared to first, and both of them looks regular format. But I think it's hard to make a comment to the features of third and fourth layer features. You can also notice that the particles have a dynamic in different frames, which is a sign of learning temporal information, in my opinion. And these are also what is learned by different channels in this second layer. You can see that filters are learned, and these are progressed to the third and fourth layer, the outputs of these channels information. So thank you for listening. I want to acknowledge CISER project, Newton Katip Çelebi project for funding our master study. And I also want to thank the TÜBİTAK Ulakbem resources, Turba resources. And these are the GitHub page if you are interested in, which is the late temporal modeling 3D CNNs. And thank you for listening. If you have a question, I want to answer that.
Thank you, Esat. That was really extensive.
Yeah, it's a little bit complex. I cannot compress the contents of the slides to be meaningful way. So my presentation is worse because of that. Sorry for some of the misconceptions, some of the misunderstandings or confusing parts.
Oh, that's okay. Any questions from the audience? Okay, I know the work, so I don't have any questions. Okay, let me stop recording, then we can maybe continue in informally in Turkish. Okay, thank you, Esat, again. So we will continue in Turkish.
Okay.